Hi, everybody. My name is Christy. Welcome to Art Minute. If this is the first time that you're joining me, you should know that I'm a professional art teacher and an illustrator, and I'm here to share some tips and tricks to make you better at drawing. And all of my instructions for Art Minutes are really short, like really bite-sized opportunities for you to do some exercises that should help improve your skills. But that don't feel overwhelming. So today we're going to talk about shading. This is really important because shading is something that a lot of people struggle with, but it also is something that a lot of people want to get better at. And really the trick to shading is just pencil pressure. So first of all, shading is really the ability to show the different values from dark to light in your work. And this means that if you're drawing something that is a complex shape, that shading can be really, really intimidating because if you're drawing a face, for example, then all the different nuances and shapes and hills and valleys of a face shift and change depending on the lighting, and the shading can really help you describe all of that. But if you're feeling really shaky about your shading to begin with, then that's going to feel like an impossible task. So what I'm going to show you how to do today is an exercise that takes out all of the guesswork about what you're drawing and just lets you practice getting the right pencil pressure so that you can get dark tones and light tones out of your pencils without worrying about what you're drawing. So I call these shading tornadoes. I'm going to show you exactly how to do them. And your homework is to fill up a whole page worth of them. You'll see in the example that I'm about to show you that it's a fairly simple thing, but you definitely have the ability to get better at it as you go, and it is a really valuable exercise to do. You can use it for your warm-ups or whatever. I still do them all the time. As a good way to kind of meditate while I'm drawing, to practice my hand-eye coordination, and to really get more control over my pencils. So I'm going to show you right now how to do it.
Okay, so here I have a 2H pencil, an HB pencil, and a 4B pencil. If you don't know what those letters and numbers mean, then you can cycle backwards to the episode that I did on pencils, which I will put a link to in the description. So I'm going to start with a 2H pencil. It's nice and light. So the tornado that you're going to do is you're going to, it's funny because it literally looks like a tornado. So you're going to get the darkest tone that you can get out of your pencil, and then just release the pressure on that pencil until it's almost nothing. And you want a very smooth gradient, so you don't want it to look choppy, or you don't want to see the steps change as you get from dark to light. So you don't want to press too hard with your pencil. So you don't want to press hard enough that you are damaging your paper. Which means that if you can feel the dent in the paper where you've drawn, that means you're pressing too hard. So if you need to go back on your tornado to even it out, then that's okay too. And the more gradual you can change the tone, the better. Okay, so I'm gonna do a couple with different types of pencils. This is a HB pencil. I'll write that down. Which is just a little bit softer than the 2H pencil. As you can see, it's a little bit darker. And I can see even here that the changeover from the dark to the medium is sort of abrupt. So I can go back, smooth it out, and there we go. So your ability to get dark and light tones from one pencil and to do it in a really smooth way is going to really change your ability to do some shading, okay? And it's just all about control. So you'll see the darker your pencil is, the harder it is to get the light tones, because you have to be pressing so light on this on the pencil. So that means that if you really want a light tone when you're doing shading, it's all about choosing the appropriate pencil. So this is a 2H and is much easier to get a light tone than with the 4B pencil. And that's what it's for. It's to get the lighter tones in your work. Okay, that's why you have different kinds of pencils. So your homework is to fill up a whole sheet with these tornadoes and try to get them as a smooth and gradual a shift from dark to light as you can. And as per always, let me know if you have any questions. Don't forget to subscribe and happy drawing.